ना? सो थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू सो मच ऑल डिवोटीज फॉर विशिंग मी दैट कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस बर्थडे. सो आई प्रे टू ऑल द डिवोटीज दैट प्लीज प्रे टू राधा कृष्ण श्री श्री राधा रास बिहारी दैट आई ऑलवेज सर्व यू, ऑलवेज सर्व द डिवोटीज एंड ऑलवेज सर्व द वैष्णवाज एंड लोटस फीट ऑफ श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण. हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण. सो माय कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस जर्नी इज जस्ट लाइक अ लिटिल बिट ट्रेजेडी. कमिंग इन कृष्णा कॉन्शियस इज जस्ट अ डिफरेंट वे दैट आई रियली दैट डिडंट थिंक अबाउट दिस दैट हाउ आई केम लाइक दिस इन कृष्णा कॉन्शियस. सो आई वेरी थैंकफुल टू द श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण एंड द डिवोटीज ऑफ द ISKCON Juhu and devotees of the Gita for Youth families. Thank you so much being with me and associating. I get a very nice association of yours. And my Krishna consciousness journey is just like that. When I was in 12th standard, I readed Bhagavad Gita 3 to 4 times, but not a Srila Prabhupada Bhagavad Gita. It's all about Gita for Youth, not Gita for Youth, but Gita Gorakhpur Press. As you know, I think so, some of you devotees know about the Gita Press, Gorakhpur. So I had read that Bhagavad Gita for 3 to 4 times. But then also, I didn't consider as Krishna as a Supreme Lord. I don't know why I didn't consider, but in that Bhagavad Gita is also it is written that Krishna is Supreme Person. But I don't believe. I think that only Shiva is the Supreme Person. But then after, I just always meditate and chant the holy name of Lord Shiva. But after slowly, slowly, gradually, I progress in devotional service of Lord Shiva. I used to chant his holy name. But after joining college, my college has started. So the devotional path is completely that time stopped. I'm totally busy in my material life. So that's why I just stop my all the devotion and taking the holy name of Lord Shiva. And then suddenly, what happened after, as you all know, that lockdown, coronavirus came and lockdown happened. So that is the my first turning point of a spiritual journey. And that is the my beginning of the spiritual journey that I started. I started to search about that what is the supreme truth. That I had, I only know that this Lord Shiva is the supreme personality of God. But then also he is meditating on some other personality. Although I am chanting his holy name, I believe in him. So I always have a question: if he is supreme, then he why he is meditating on who is from whom he is meditating? If he is supreme, then there is no need to meditate on others. So that's why I start the journey of searching that when I got the one videos of ISKCON of as you all know the famous personality Amoghalila Prabhu and all the devotees other devotees of ISKCON. And then I little bit I just started watching of videos of ISKCON and I started hearing of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. Gradually I start hearing. Then I come to know about this Vaishnava Sampradaya, and then I come to know about this ISKCON, that how ISKCON is a spiritual society and the spiritual organization that anyone can join in this society and in this organization and take the advantage of his spiritual life. He can take the advantage of human life, and that is the ultimate goal of everyone, as you all know. And then also I just believe that okay they are telling that Krishna is supreme, but I at the time of I convinced that okay Narayan is the supreme personality of God and not Krishna. So then I little bit research means that research also then I have had I had read many of the other scriptures like not that whole book. I just seen the quotes and all the other refer the other shlokas from the different Purans and all that from the websites, and I searched that oh that Krishna is supreme. from the Krishna, all these many, many avatars come. So by this, gradually I come in Krishna consciousness, but I didn't come in any devotee association. Then for 1 or 2 months, I always pray to Lord Krishna that, okay, that I have seen all the background of the devotees and your associates, the Vaishnavas. I have seen the background of devotees and Vaishnavas and all the spiritual organization. I have seen all the backgrounds and what is the going on, how they are dealing with the peoples, how they are doing spreading the message of Lord Shri Krishna, spreading the message of Bhagavad Gita. So I have seen all these things. But then my desire increases that if that Lord Shri Krishna is supreme, then how his devotees is look like and how they behave, how they interact with others, and what they eat, how they walk. As there are many questions regarding the spiritual, that how that Arjuna have questions that how the devotee of yours walk, talk, sleep, and interact with the people. Similarly, that type of a question arises in my mind. So I pray very intensely, very heartily that I want to meet your devotees. So by mercy of Sri Sri Radharas Bihari, that one day Janudev Prabhu and the whole traveling Sankirtan party, I don't know how it's happened, but very small town, when I'm living at that town, all the devotees and traveling Sankirtan party visited, and I meet all the devotees and I have a very good time with them. And I know that December 27, not 27, sorry, 17, the date when I meet all the devotees, and I know that with date that December 20, I joined my first session of Gita for Youth, and from there my spiritual journey starts. And that's only Hare Krishna. Thank you so much, devotees. Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Shreyas Prabhu, for sharing your journey, your starting in Krishna consciousness, how you came into Krishna consciousness, and how in search of who is the supreme, that you came across devotees from traveling Sankirtan party, and Janaji Prabhu is also there in that bus party.
Yes.
So that's a very wonderful and inspiring journey, Prabhu, because I see that within a very short span, within less than 1 year, you have came across Krishna consciousness and you took it very seriously, and you have never reduced and never neglected your sadhana, and you are such an inspiring devotee, Prabhu, really. We'll talk about what all the other devotees have, their interactions and their memories with you in the Krishna conscious journey after Janadev Prabhuji's response. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Voice is audible to everyone?
Yes, Prabhu.
Yes. Hare Krishna. So thank you all for joining on the Gita for Youth to celebrate this occasion of birthday of Shreyas Prabhu, Bhakta Shreyas Prabhu. So today is one of the most auspicious day of Sri Bhugarbha Goswami's disappearance day. And also today is Sri Kashishwara Pandit disappearance day. Disappearance day means they have left their bodies in this world, but they are eternally went to the spiritual abode of Krishna. So Vaishnava's birthdays means appearance days, and Vaishnava's disappearance days, both we celebrate as a great festival. So taking this opportunity of celebrating this great Vaishnava's acharyas and the birthday of our dear Bhakta Shreyas Prabhu, I wish Bhakta Shreyas Prabhu happy Krishna conscious birthday. And I pray to Sri Radha Rasa Bihari, Srila Prabhupada, Sri Gaur Nithai, that our dear Shesh Prabhu should never take birth again in this material world. If at all he should take for preaching Krishna consciousness, delivering the conditioned souls. And my interaction with Shesh Prabhu, literally speaking, I have not met him, even though I was there in the bus party that time. But one of my students, Bhakta Akhilesh Yadav Prabhu, he met him. Shesh Prabhu, I hope you remember Akhilesh Yadav Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu, I remember all the devotees, Akhilesh Prabhu and all other devotees.
Shesh Prabhu in the bus party, in the traveling Sankirtan bus party. So when he met Akhilesh Yadav Prabhu, he spoke to me about the Shesh Prabhu and his great desire to become Krishna conscious. Then I asked Akhilesh Prabhu to follow him up, be in touch with him, find out his birthday, interact with him. We sent some books and some feedback, something like that. So that's how Akhilesh Yadav Prabhu introduced me, the Shreyas Prabhu to me. From that time onwards, I was personally on phone in touch with Shreyas Prabhu. Sometimes we had a video call. I could see his face. And in Zoom, when he was joining on Gita for Youth sessions, when he's joining. So I could see him on video. And I was introduced to his brother also through Shreyas Prabhu, Harsh Prabhu. Yes, Harsh Panchal. Is he there?
Yes. No, Prabhu.
Prabhu is not there. So both the brothers, very, very serious in Krishna consciousness. Both brothers. In my interaction, I felt Shreyas Prabhu is very much inspired by YouTubers. It's called YouTubers. Like, for example, Amogalila Prabhu, Amarendra Prabhu, some sannyasis, Srila Prabhupada videos directly. When he came in touch with me, Hare Krishna, when he came in touch with me, I spoke with him very strongly about one important lesson. The lesson is, nowadays many, many youngsters, many people in the world, they are getting attracted to the YouTubers. They are following them in their YouTube channels. They became a dedicated followers of such people. But hardly there is someone practically in touch with any devotee in ISKCON. I generally tell this. Does Amogalila Prabhu, Shreyas Prabhu knows about Shreyas Prabhu knows about Amogalila Prabhu. But does Amogalila Prabhu knows about Shreyas Prabhu?
No. Absolutely not.
If at all, one time, Amogalila Prabhu's birthday was there. I wished him on my phone. I called him up and wished. Then Shreyas Prabhu also got to know Amogalila Prabhu's birthday was there. Then I immediately shared the contact of Amogalila Prabhu to Shreyas Prabhu. I think he spoke to him. He wished him.
Yes,
but I don't know. Shreyas Prabhu called me afterwards. He shared his experience. He was busy, all that. So practically I guided in one sense, in one of the important lessons which I gave to Shreyas Prabhu. And generally I give this lesson to most of the devotees who are on YouTube platform. What I say is, there should be someone in our life who are practically guiding us in day-to-day life. If at all we do some mistake, the devotee should correct us. If we do something great, the devotee should appreciate us. But like all the YouTubers doesn't have that much time to be in touch with everyone and practically each and everyone. So that's why I suggested for Gita for Youth, coming on the platform of Gita for Youth and joining for sessions. He's in, from that time onwards, he took my suggestion very seriously, Shreyas Prabhu. He is trying to practice Krishna consciousness. We can take inspiration from many, many Vaishnavas, online, offline. But there should be someone in our life who can correct us, guide us practically day-to-day life. I'm very, very happy with the Shreyas Prabhu. He is very, very serious in Krishna consciousness and practically taking the guidance. And serving Krishna at his level best. Nicely, he wonderfully makes Ekadashi posters, Ekadashi short videos, and he makes Gita for Youth quotations. Recently, he started making very wonderfully. And he manages, he serves online services, Gita for Youth media, he serves very actively. So I thank Shreyas Prabhu for all the services rendering. And I wish once again, happy Krishna conscious birthday, Shreyas Prabhu. My only desire is every day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year, our Shreyas Prabhu devotion for Krishna, towards Krishna, should increase and increase and increase. That's only my only desire. Thank you, Shreyas Prabhu. Thank you, Prashant Prabhu, for hosting this and inviting me for this event for Shreyas Prabhu's birthday. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Thank you so much, Prabhu, for telling such a good thing, Prabhu. I only say to the all devotees that devotees, I know you all that you are from, I think so, from different states. And I know that you all are in Devotees Association. You are so much fortunate that you are personally touching all the devotees. And it is a very rare opportunity that we get a devotee association. In my case, I am very so unfortunate that I don't have any personal touch with the devotees. But yes, online is there. Online is there. We are in meeting in Zoom. So that's a little bit good thing. But you are so fortunate that you have personal association of all these devotees. And you must follow the Prabhus and all the Vaishnavas in the temple. You must all serve that devotees, because this devotees association is very rare and very jewel, very like a Chintamani. Means that Chintamani is also there, and even the Parasmani also there. If you touch the Parasmani, you become like a golden and effulgent. So similarly, the devotees are just like a Parasmani. They are golden jewel. If you touch them, then you will also become a gold. So please take this seriously, that it is a very rare that you get a devotee association. In my town, in where I am living, there is also there, Vaishnava temple is also there, but from the different sampradaya. And very less devotees are there in here in my town. So I am not so much fortunate that I have that type of association like you all have. But I'm very happy that I'm in touch with all devotees, and especially as Janudip Prabhu and other all devotees which I met in traveling Sankirtan party, and especially to the Prashant Prabhu also. Thank you so much, Prabhus. Thank you so much. I only pray that please, Prabhus, pray to Krishna that I become a devotee at one day, Prabhu. Hare yes. Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much, Shreyas Prabhu, for your response.
Hare Krishna. Can I add one more line?
Sure, Prabhu.
Yes, sure, Prabhu.
So many times we think that, yes, once I will tell one past time. Srila Prabhupada, he was sitting in Bhagavatam class. He was explaining about Sadhu Sangha. Because all the Shastras, they say this. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sakala Shastra Kahe. Sadhu Sangha, Sakala Shiddhi Hoi. So by association of sadhus, one becomes a sadhu. So our life is to become a gentleman, sadhu. That happens only when we associate with devotees. So Prabhupada was explaining like this in a sadhu sangha to the disciples while speaking in a Rasasam. Then Prabhupada, suddenly one makki, one fly came and sat on the Prabhupada's hand. One makki, fly. Then Prabhupada said, Is this fly taking my association? Prabhupada asked. Then Prabhupada started explaining. He asked this question and started explaining. So just by sitting nearby, just because sitting nearby, that fly is not taking the association of Prabhupada. But people who are hearing in the Bhagavatam class, people who are far away, distant place in London, Europe, somewhere, but hearing Prabhupada's tape. So they are actually taking the Prabhupada association. Still now we are taking the association of Prabhupada by hearing his lectures, by hearing his instructions, by reading his books. This is the way we are taking the association of Prabhupada. This is a Vani Seva. So Sadhu Sangha doesn't mean alone that being personally in touch, sitting nearby, eating together or sleeping together. No, this is not the meaning of Sadhu Sangha. Sadhu Sangha really means getting the instructions and following the instructions is actually Sadhu Sangha. And another third point is getting the instruction, taking the instructions from sadhu. This is the first thing. And second thing is following that instruction. And third thing is most important. Third thing is taking the corrections from that sadhu. That is another third thing is very important. So this is actually real sadhu sangha. Even though most of us are not in touch, we have not seen each other, not met each other, but still we are in the parampara, okay, taking the guidance from Prabhupada, following his instructions and having a practical guide in our life, who are practically guiding us day-to-day life. Thank you, Prashant Prabhu. Once again, I wish Shreyas Prabhu happy Krishna Conscious Birthday.
Thank you so much, Prabhu.
Thank you so much, Prabhu. Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you, Shreyas Prabhu. And I request all the devotees to share about Shreyas Prabhu, your interaction with Shreyas Prabhu. We have 5 minutes left, so you can just explain or share your experience with Shreyas Prabhu. You can explain about how Shreyas Prabhu is eager to serve Gita for Youth and Krishna through Gita for Youth. And what is your interaction with Shreyas Prabhu? Yeah, in one line you can share. Yes, come on, Arjun Prabhu, Avish Prabhu, Abhyuday Prabhu.
Yes, Arjun Prabhu, say something about Shreyas Prabhu, what you felt inspired by him. Arjun Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Babaji.
Hare Krishna.
Yes. Yes, sir. Happy Krishna Consciousness Birthday to Shreyas Prabhuji. Yes. So, I have learned many things from Shreyas Prabhu, like serious devotion towards Lords, and always Shreyas Prabhu, always Shreyas Prabhu is eager to serve Krishna. And I have seen one thing that whenever some seva is there, and like once a time like a class was there, and I'm busy, and I requested Shreyas Prabhu. Shreyas Prabhu is having fever. He is having fever, headache. But I tell him that please, Prabhuji, please do this seva. This is very important. So Shreyas Prabhu not say anything. He says simply that yes, I'll do that seva. Don't worry, Prabhu. He is having fever and headache, but still he is serving Krishna. That we can learn from him. And at that time, I learned that whatever little thing, excuses we have, but if we really want to serve Krishna, then no excuses can be stop us. So we should never make excuses in Krishna consciousness. That I love learned from Shreyas Prabhu. So thank you, Prabhuji, for having your association. We are learning more and more things from you. Yes, and also from other devotees. Yes, Prabhu. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna, thank you, Arjun Prabhu. Yes, I have seen the eagerness and that fire in Shreyas Prabhu, that I want to serve devotees, I want to serve Krishna in some way, one way or other way. Even though he's busy or he's with all the other stuff he has, he wants to serve devotees. Whether it may be his interest in Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita or to make digital content, whatever that service it may be, he's always raising his hand to take that opportunity and to increase his devotion towards Krishna. That's very inspiring, Shreyas Prabhu. I also get a lot of motivation and inspiration looking at all the devotees like you. Thank you so much for being with us as a member of Gita for Youth family. And I wish you and all the other devotees to never leave this Gita for Youth family. I want all the devotees to come together and reach Goloka. Let's all take the association of Prabhuji and reach Goloka. So I don't want any of us to break this journey, to walk out in this beautiful journey. So thank you. Thank you so much, Shreyas Prabhu, for being with us.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Any Hare other Krishna. Devotees?
Yes, Abhyuday Prabhu.
He's,
Abhyuday Prabhu, can you add one line?
There's some noise, it seems, Prabhu, on his side.
Prabhuji, here is lots of noise because of your election, panchayat election. That's why I will write in the group, Prabhuji.
Yeah, your wish, Prabhu. That's okay. We understand. Okay. Avish Prabhu says, Shreyas Prabhu is always very eager for preparing slides for Bhagavatam class and Ekadasi reminders and always ready to serve God. Yeah. So he's very eager. He has that desire to serve devotees and to serve Krishna in one way or the other. Always. Thanks. Thanks, Avish Prabhu. Thank you, Shreyas Prabhu. Thank you so much. I wish you again happy Krishna conscious birthday. So I also desire that you never take birth again in this material world. So I hope you realize one day the purpose of your birth. Hare Krishna.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, Prabhu. Thank you so much, you all devotees. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Shreyas Prabhu. Happy Krishna conscious birthday. May Srila Prabhupada also engage you in fully in the service of the Lord. Hare Krishna.
My great desire, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, devotees, for participating. Hare Krishna. Brilliant.